Hello, my dear friends. Today in this video, I will discuss with you all about to the difference between the index and citation databases. So what are those differences? And then after, I will try to cover the role of the Google Scholar, or you can say where the Google Scholar basically stands in between these two, whether that lies in index database or in citation database. Right, so this is the title of the video, and the plan of this video will remain actually for those who are in the primary stage of their research career, or those who are basically doing their research course, right, research and publication ethics course in India. So this topic will cover all related information, like we will understand that what is the repository, then after we will understand metadata, right? Then after we will divide indexer into two categories. One is the journal indexing category, and second is the article indexing category, and then further about to their information that what is index databases and how the index databases collect the information about the journal only, and which are basically popular databases are available, and then after with some example I will try to explain so you the idea basically get clear at your end. Then next thing will remain about to the article indexer, and here you will get information about to the citation database and which agencies are basically most popular in the defining the matrices, all about to the, you can say, publication matrices or research matrices. But the more effective word will be here, the publication matrices. So these two agencies will provide the information about to the citation of the articles, right, in terms of the impact factor as well as in terms of the H index. So that point we will discuss. Then after getting the information about to the journal indexing and the citation indexing of the article, we will see closely to the Google Scholar, that where Google Scholar basically lies in between these two, because Google Scholar provide the citations and H index of the author. So how I will try to explain that. So let's approach towards that. And so for the index database, I will try to explain related things so you get basically information about to that, how they collect the information about to the journal. So you can see here my profile page, and here I have applied for the ERIH plus indexing, that is known as basically European Research Index for the humanities and social science. Right, so this will remain the a discussion about to that, and I will try to show you the live example so you can get the information. Right, you can see here three journals, and out of these three, one is approved for the indexing, and that is Issues and Idea in Education. This journal is indexed into the ERIH plus database, and this is you can say this is the index database. So what the information they have, they in general collect all the information first of all about to the journal publisher, and then after decide on the basis of the quality of the journal, that journal and the discipline that journal will exist into the database or not. Right, so here you can see on this particular page the title of the journal, international title, what is the URL of the journal, then language, print ISSN number, electronic international standard serial number, right, publisher name and discipline, editorial board link, peer review process, authorship, abstracts, all these information you can find out here. So these are some comments related to it, and now we will see actually how basically and what the information they collect. So let's see here. I want to submit a journal into the index database. So what they do, they provide some form, and in that form basically either the editor or publisher required to fill some information as per the requirement. Like here, if you want to submit your journal into the ERH Plus, and you then what you have to do, you have to basically provide that information, and what is the procedure for that. If you are looking that, then you have to read this particular link. I just click it and can show you that what are the procedure for that. This information is available, so one can read from here. The link will be available into the description. Right, second thing is about to the that what information a index database collect from the journal, everything related to the journal, right? Title of the journal, name of the publisher, and this information, print ISSN number, electronic original title, international title, what is the URL, in which language basically they are publishing the content, or the name of the publisher, and then after discipline, in which discipline basically that particular journal lies, whether that lies in history or into the literature or in law or in archaeology, cultural studies, like this. So in which discipline that journal lies, that in you have to tick here, like this one, right? Then after you have to provide the editorial board link, the URL of that one, peer review, similarly you have to provide the URL of that, authorship URL, and then you have to provide the page of the abstract. And here you, if you are interested to provide any other information, you can write from here. And the processing time, they are telling that they will take near about how much money. Right, so these are the information which index database collects. So all this information is related to the journal. So in my presentation, I told you that why I'm using this journal indexer, right? This category, because in this category, what is happening? The data index database basically is collecting the information only about to the journal, whether the journal basically is sustainable or not, how much article that journal is providing, what is the quality status, what is the quality status, and other information related to the journal. So index database collect only the information of the journal and its quality publication. Second thing comes about to the directory of open access journal. This is the directory of only of the open access journals, right? Whether those are publishing with the different license, but all the journals are listed in this particular database. So this is index database. Next thing comes that how to define article indexer or citation database. So when you collect the information about to the articles, right, so how the articles basically are getting cited into the different journals, or different journals are using your articles, so that information becomes important. So here into the citation database, what happened basically, not only about to the journal, but also focused remain on the articles, right? How basically the article is citing another references, and how the another journals basically taking the reference of this journal, right? You can say in terms of the article. So there are mainly two agencies that basically provide the parameter to judge the journal on the basis of their citation. One is the Web of Science. Here, Web of Science provide the impact factor actually, and Scopus provide the H index by which you can basically determine the value of a researcher or a institution, right? And from that you can analyze the theme. So in the next video I will provide about the information about to the impact factor and H index, and some facts related to that facts related to the impact factor, that how impact factor can basically provide the information, and what the facts that you are not aware about to the impact factor as well as of H index. So that will remain a part of discussion into the next video. Here my purpose was just to provide you information about to the index database and citation database. So this is an example of the index database. So here you can find out all the information related to the journal. So if you need to find out the journals in any area, you can find out. Suppose I want to find out all the physics journal which are listed here. This is the open access directory. So 320 index journals are available. So here you can basically read everything about to the journal, like Frontiers in Heat Pipes. So how much basically they are charging, and about to the website, is this listed or not, and what type of license they are providing to the author. Website, how much charging they are taking, and then after article processing charge, if they are supposed taking, then in that particular condition. Materials of quantum technology, here you can see the update information of the journal, and then after website, and how much the charges they are taking to publish the article. License is with the CC BY. So I will also discuss about to the CC BY in earlier videos. Some year before, so I had discussed about to it. Now if you think that I need to explain about to the license as well as copyright, so you can comment into the comment box, and then after I will try to cover all those video also. So this is an example of the index database. Now here through this ImagoJR you can find out all the information about to the journals, and here journal ranking, etc. So all this value basically, cite score, SGR, H index, it depends on the citation of the article, right, in a journal. So all that information, this is the citation, you can say, database. And if you want to know more about to this Web of Science, then you have to approach this Clarivate Analytics website, and this website basically provide the impact factor of the journals through the journal citation report. So this will be a citation database. So in our discussion, I had asked in the beginning that what are the differences between the index and citation database. So what do you think that these are the differences between the index and citation databases? In the index database, you have seen that index database collect the information of only the journal, not the article. How basically article are performing, that comes into the citation database. They collect all the information related to the journal as well as of the published research article, right? So they analyze all that thing. But now here my question is related to the Google Scholar. How basically Google Scholar stand in this process? I am taking an example of myself also here, and you can see that citation are only 219 and H index is 6. So in this process, what is happening, The Google Scholar is providing not only citation but H index also, right? And within with this information, when you will use Google Scholar, so from the Google Scholar you can also find out the published article. Suppose I have to find out any article related to the physics, medicine, biology, like this. So I want to read any particular article, so this article is available. So here this Google Scholar basically collecting the article information, right? So now you have to decide, and let me click it, and then we will see. So here this is a book chapter, but my purpose is to find out the research article. So this is again book Journal of Materials Chemistry. So this is an article published into this particular journal, right? But the purpose of to show it, the purpose of it is actually to show you how basically Google Scholar is collecting the information. So Google Scholar is not collecting the information about to the journal. It is collecting the information directly of the research article. So because of that point, it is telling you that this is the, these are the total number of citation here, and on that basis it is calculating H index, right? So at the first instance it seems that Google Scholar is a citation database, right? So on the basis of this analysis, we can see that Google Scholar, this Google Scholar comes into the citation database. Right, so it collects the information of the journal as well as of the research article. So citation database basically collects the information of the research article. Right, but how these whether that is in case of index, this journal index, right? Or you can say how basically index database collect the information. This index database does not collect all the information automatically like Google Scholar. They actually, you have to apply there, and after reviewing your application, they collect the information about to the journal and the articles. On that basis, they basically evaluate the journals at different stages, and then they approve their indexing into that particular database, right? So here into the Google Scholar, you have seen that it is providing the citation of your published article and together they are providing H index. But what is into the practice? In practice, you may have seen here that in general, people actually, researchers, put their profile onto the auto mode. So what happens? So when Google Scholar basically see the name of a specific researcher XYZ, right, and if it is, it found the similar name anywhere into the public with the published article, so that basically add that particular paper into the researcher's profile. So what is happening, because of this auto mode, you can see the people basically have large number of the citation, right? Because they have keep their profile, research profile on auto mode. So Google Scholar algorithm basically is designed by that way. If that find any similar name or almost same name, so that basically include the article into your profile. And because of this reason, the citation get increased. And many times you have seen that still people are not involved into the many different multidisciplinary research, but they are getting a citation into the thousands. So you can take or you can find out this kind of an example from anywhere. So if you will basically let's search or try to find out search provided from the BHU. So here you can see the person from the BHU, the citation of this professor, assistant professor into the BHU, that citation is around 81,000. And here Sri Singh, the person belongs to the physics department, and here citation you can see 39,000. And similarly you can see in any IIT, right? For an example, IIT Roorkee. So let's see the profile of the people from there. So here are the professor Deva Datta Das. He's basically in his profile you can see 38,000 citations. So if you will see or will try to verify all these things, so let's see into the IIT Mumbai also. So here you can see Piyali Banerjee is the postdoctoral researcher in physics IIT Bombay, and her citation is 2,10,000. So you can find out these kind of information from the Google profile, and let's see this really exists or not. So here you can see this Piyali Banerjee. The first article is this one, and we can understand that this article basically related to the CERN experiment. So because of that citation may be of this, but this article was published in 2008. Next, related to the ATLAS simulation infrastructure, again this is article, this article published with large number of the authors. So if there are 1,000 authors and those people again write an article and using this particular article in their manuscript, so obviously they will get so much citation. So here on every article they are getting basically large number of the citations, right? So here because a list is so long, so there may be a probability, right, in this situation. So here you can see overall citation is 2,10,000. And this is the case of high energy physics. And here Mukul Kumar from 27,000. So let's see his profile. And from his profile you can see his name Mukul Kumar. And this is the genome sequence, comparative genome. People are working in carbon nanotube, CVD, camphor, catalysis, field emission. And here genome sequence and least square twin support vector mechanics for pattern classification, randomized trial of intrapneural urokinase treatment of childhood emphysema. So by this way actually my purpose to show you all about to these things, that Google Scholar profile and Google Scholar citation and H index. When you require to actually discuss all about to these things, that how Google Scholar is providing citation and H index, we have to put it into the citation database or index database. So it is very clear that we will put this Google Scholar into the citation database. Right, but the problem is here related to the impact factor by which some journal basically provide the impact factor on the basis of Google Scholar citation. In this particular analysis at the end, I have shown you that how basically the people, if are not taking care of their Google Scholar profile properly, or then they are getting a random number, and that number is so big, so they are getting enough number of citation. And this thing may be happen with the anything. If they had created a profile of the institution, or if they had created a profile of the journal on Google Scholar, so by that way actually they are getting the random number, and that is not fixed. Till that, you are not managing the Google Scholar profile into the manual mode. So that thing is important, and if one is basically interested to find out the Google Scholar manual procedure, then they have to see actually all these things. So just click here on the plus sign, and you can see here add article manually, add articles group. So configure article updates. Just click it and see here that there are two options: automatically update the list of article in my profile. Most of the time it is a recommended part, so Google Scholar automatically keep it. And second thing is this one: don't automatically update my profile, send me email to review the confirm. So there are many suggestions like this time. These are the article which are available, right, and these are suggestions which you can see. So by this way, you need to update all the article manually here into the Google Scholar profile. So in the whole video, if you see the analysis, so my purpose was to provide the information that how you can make the difference between the index database and citation database. So index database, what is the requirement? They just see only the journal information, right? Into the citation base, they not only see the journal information, but they also see the quality of the paper and how basically the article are performing in terms of their citation. So citation database and index database, they are two things. But in this process, what we are missing? We are missing repository and metadata. So these are basically, whether that is a journal indexer or citation indexer, article indexer, you can say. Right, both are connected with the repositories, and these repositories basically collect the digital information of an object. Collect the digital object information, and this digital object may be an article or a journal. And how basically they are collecting, that is known as metadata. So in case of article, right, suppose you are providing here the article information. So in the article, you know that first number comes about to the journal information. So you write the name of the journal at the top, their volume, their issue number, page number, year, etc. And then after comes about to the title of the journal, right? Then after author's name, their affiliation, right? And then after, what do you think that it will come? The email ID of the corresponding author. So corresponding author, then abstract, keywords, means every type, everything comes into that one, that metadata. Metadata is the your headings, subheadings, your images table, or the references, everything that basically you provide into the piece form, right? into the article. So that is known as the metadata. So all that information basically the citation database collect. Right, there are some metadata harvested. So using that basically that collect the information of metadata in XML form. Right, so these are some technical points. I don't want to go into the detail because of that the video get so lengthy and you can lose your interest. My purpose, again I am repeating, was to explain about to the difference between index and citation databases and role of the or position of the Google Scholar in the index and citation database. So that thing I had explained here. I hope you had get an idea. If you had get an idea, if further you want any video on a specific topic related to your research and publication course or in general, you can comment into the comment box. So thanks for watching this video and for your time.